API stands for Application Programming Interface. API integration is fashionable. It is close to impossible to find a modern web application that doesn't expose an API. This is fabulous news for integration, but it leaves behind the backbone of IT infrastructure today, the legacy applications that businesses rely on for day-to-day processes. Using API integration, it allows the software or web applications to communicate with other software in a programmatic way. UiPath builds a bridge between the new and the old world by automating in the same script web services and legacy applications. So, UiPath works both ways by extracting data from one application and pass it to a web service, or vice versa, retrieving data from a web service and automating the UI with it. While you already know how UiPath automate user interface, I'll show you today how you can call a web service to get a weather information for a specific city. A web service is the most common way to connect two application or electronic devices over the internet. The two most common type of web service we'll discuss is SOAP and REST. We will divide this video into two parts. First, we will use SOAP, which stands for Simple Object Access Protocol. Some of the websites that use SOAP API are eBay and Salesforce. SOAP uses XML files to transport data, and REST usually uses JSON. Let me show you how it is done. In the design menu, click on Web API. Select SOAP Client. It will give you the SOAP Request Wizard. We can put in the link to the web service under Service Description. Let me open a sample website. Here, I have a sample public SOAP service called Global Weather. If I click on this link, it will show you the code of an XML file containing the web service description. Let's go back and let's copy the SOAP service link. Then we go to the UiPath and paste the link here. Once done, we can click Get. This will load the content of the XML file. Now we have an option to select the contract and method that retrieves the data we want to fetch. Selecting a method will automatically change the required parameters as well. So, if we choose the method getCitiesByCountry, it gives country name. Let's select getWeather method, which will retrieve the current weather in the city we specified. Let's type in New York for the city and United States for the country. Some SOAP requires authentication. Since we're using a public service, let's leave it as none. Let's click on Invoke to preview the result. It successfully retrieved the data. To save this activity, let's click on Generate Activity. In our workflow, we have a new activity called SOAP Client. Let's set it as a start node. Let's rename it to make it more readable. Let's open the GetWeather activity and let's review the properties of this activity. The endpoint is the URL of the web service. We also have specified a contract name and method to be generated. If we click on the parameters, we have the default values for city and country, which we can replace using variables. The output of this activity is produced through this variable, SOAP Client. Let's rename it. Let's go to the variables panel and rename the variable here. Let's say SOAP Result. Then let's change the scope to main so we can use it later globally. Let's test the result by adding a write line activity. Let's put in a variable of the SOAP activity, which is SOAP result. Let's run it. Great! Here's the result, which is currently an XML in a text format. As you can see, it captures all available content based on specified parameters. In UiPath, we can further customize the output by extracting specific data from an XML result. To extract data from an XML file, we can use a special activity called deserialize XML. This activity converts text XML files in an XML document that we can easily manipulate. Let's use it in our workflow. Let's open it and specify the XML string we want to convert. Let's put in the output variable for the SOAP activity. The output of this serialized activity is saved in the XML document variable. Let's rename it XML doc. This data type will help us easily extract and manipulate data contained in the XML tree structure. Left-sided right-line activity. To retrieve specific data in an XML document, we can use this simple code. The XML doc is the output result of the XML file we used in the previous activity. Then we will enclose the specific elements we want to capture. Let's go back to the XML result. As you can see, the structure of the XML file has a root element, current weather. If we have multiple child elements, we'll try to extract the temperature. So we can type in xmldoc.element, enclose the current weather, which is the root element, dot element temperature, which is the child element, dot value, which will capture the value inside the temperature tag, and dot toString, which will convert the value to the basic string format. That's it! Let's run it. Perfect, that's our output data. You just learned how to use UiPath to extract data from a SOAP web service and capture specific data from it. This is a sample and non-intrusive automation, yet a powerful solution in extracting data and provide a seamless integration between web apps and services. In the next video, I'm going to demonstrate another type of web service called REST. Thanks for watching.